Finally tonight, we often get lost in frantic daily routines, rush hour, work, school, smartphones buzzing all day long. Too much to do with too little time. But now and again, we check in on a reporter whose life's work now is found in walking and taking meaning and telling stories from his years of footsteps. Ari Srinivasan has this update.
You know, the walk's kind of turned into my life.
In October 2015, I went for a walk in the Southern Caucasus Mountains with the journalist Paul Salopan. For me, it was a few days. For him, he had been walking nearly 3 years as part of his Out of Eden walk, a global journey by foot. We spoke with him in Kazakhstan last year, and when he was in Kyrgyzstan earlier this year. And Paul joins me again now. Paul, tell me where you're at. I can hear a river rushing in the background.
Right now, I'm next to the banks of the Kanar River in northern Pakistan. After having just walked well over 1,000 miles to the mountains of Central Asia, starting in Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, a big chunk of Afghanistan, and now, of course, in Pakistan.
You were in Afghanistan years ago during the war. How's it changed?
You know, I've walked through a part of Afghanistan that I've only known marginally before when I was in the war. The war, I was in a hostile environment, filled with guns, filled with explosions, filled with movements of armed men, as a war correspondent. The last segment that I've walked through is a completely different Afghanistan. It's a wild, pristine, almost unknown Afghanistan to the outside world, where people are carrying not guns but shovels, where men are digging holes not to plant IEDs but to create traps for snow leopards, and women are not wrapping their faces in purga except to bake bread in smoky ovens. It's a completely different Afghanistan than the one I used to know.
You're one of the few people to cross Afghanistan on foot, right?
Yes, at least this segment that I know of. According to my research, the last time any outsiders walked through what is called the Wakhan Corridor, this really wild alpine strip of land between Tajikistan, China, and Pakistan, was probably 10 years ago, and before that, maybe generations. It's simply a roadless area. It's an area that's inhabited by shepherds. It looks like alpine parts of British Columbia or Switzerland, and it's safe to walk through.
Sounds like extreme conditions here.
Yes, to get through this region required quite a bit of logistical preparation. We had to hire some donkeys. We had to go over 14,000, 15,000, 16,000 foot passes. And the last pass, called Irshad Pass, in the wild mountains of the Karakoram between Afghanistan and Pakistan, was particularly extreme. It was so cold that even inside of my tent, my clothes froze on my body.
Given where you are now, you said your satellite phone has been confiscated. Are you concerned at all for your safety?
Yeah, it was an interesting experience coming down out of this extremely wild and high mountain wilderness in the Karakoram into Pakistan. I wasn't aware that I needed a permit for my satellite phone, so my satellite phone was confiscated. But I feel very safe here. The Pakistani authorities have done a great job of collaborating with my project and ensuring that there's overwatch, that they're keeping an eye out for me. So other than nature, which you always have to keep your eye on, I feel quite safe.
You're working on a story about the Silk Road for National Geographic. Tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, the December issue is a piece that describes the last 2,500 miles of the walk almost. It's a vast area stretching from the Caspian through Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, and Kyrgyzstan. And that piece talks about how lessons from the Silk Road, which is kind of one of the early experiments in globalization, still echo today, especially in an environment when there's a backlash against globalization. It's a story about what happens when you open up the walls of society to free trade and free ideas versus turning inwards, at which point societies stop growing.
This is the same Silk Road you've been walking along for quite some time now.
Yeah, it's been a while. It's been, I think, since May of 2015 when I set foot in Kazakhstan. So it's a big stretch of the earth, a big stretch of my global project, crossing open steppes, following the fabled Amu Darya or Oxus River through Central Asia with all these Silk Road empires along the way, these beautiful old medieval cities, and this amazing montane wilderness. It's, this last segment through Afghanistan in particular has been extraordinary. Everything from the quality of light, light like champagne, to vistas of mountain peaks stretching as far as the eye can see, to the edge of the world, to the very edge of visibility, and most of it untrammeled, unstepped on.
All right, Paul, so where to next?
Well, from here, I hope to continue down through northern Pakistan, through the foothill countries, through the capital of Islamabad, and then to the old cultural capital of Lahore, the old Mughal cultural center, into northern India, and then across northern India, into Bangladesh, and then onward into China.
Journalist Paul Salopek joining us from the hills of Pakistan tonight. Thanks so much.
It's always great to reconnect with you, Hari. Maybe I'll see you on the pilgrim trails in India.
The definition of tough is